Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
We want to specialize this time around to worship him. So we want to worship him now. So in the afternoon, as we have announced formally unto us, we will create time for fantastic prayer. So the prayer will be very, very fantastic and intensive. So it's an earnest prayer that we pray in the afternoon. Now we will only offer our God more worship for his faithfulness,
kindness,
he's a good God to us, for his goodness, for his protection over us. Let's shout one big hallelujah. Amen, amen, amen.
Amen.
Can we put our hand together unto the Lord for his goodness?
See your Lord, with the gentle Darasua.
Let's wave our hand unto our Lord Jesus. Let's spread our hand and wave our hand to the Lord. Yes, let's have joy in our heart this time around. Let's allow joy to reign in our hearts. You are already in a very special week right now. So, and I'm trusting God that is going to fulfill his wonders in our life. Change the situation of life. Every impossibility shall be turned to possible. Glory be to God in the highest, amen. Glory be to God in the highest, amen. For his mercies
we
In expressions of his goodness, to appreciate him. Let's continue to do that where you are. Remember his goodness, his kindness on you. Continue to pour out your heart right now.
Oh,
to express your thanks unto him. For he is a good God. He is nice. He is kind. He is good. He is faithful. Lord of lords. King of kings.
Oba, oba.
Immortal.
And
invisible. Thank you, Lord. 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 In Jesus' mighty name, we are praised.
Ni oruko nla Jesu Kristi ni agbadura.
In Jesus' mighty name, we offer praise.
Ni oruko Jesu Kristi ni apola fun.
Amen.
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 Just make this supplication unto him according to how he enlightened me.
Eje kaka so ile si adura te ogba si gege bi o ti fi han won baba wa.
According to his instruction to me.
Gege bi o ti dari awon baba wa.
Something that we occur this time around that we enable people to say that's good.
Nti o sele ti o mu ka won yan so pe o da ba on.
That's good.
O da ba on.
Something, do you believe in something that can happen and people will say, oh, that's good.
Se gbagbo nu kan ti o sele ta won yan so pe ah o da ba ye.
Ah ah. God has answered your prayer.
Ah, oh, that's good.
You will simply cry to the Almighty God.
Ah, okay, sir.
Oh, seriously and honestly.
Father.
Baba. Here I am.
Amen.
I want you to mark something that will enable people to say, that's good. That is his voice to me.
Oh, see our baba one. Oh, see our baba one.
Something that will prompt people saying, oh, that's good.
Until you come when you saw we pure.
Let it occur to me. Continue to make your supplication where you are. Masutai Kapuri. Yes, Lord. What will prompt people to say, oh, that's good. What will prompt people of God? What will prompt my accompanying people
to say, oh,
that's good.
That is good.
That is
upon
in my way.
Oluwaju sele ni ona me.
In my venture.
Oluwaju sele mbi se men.
Let it occur.
Oluwaju sele.
Silia Kapuria. Yes. Our hand up where we are.
Our wa loke ni biti awa.
Wherever you might be.
Ni biki biti awa wa.
In your branch, in any place or destination where this prayer reaches.
Ni biki biti adura ye ba de.
Just put your hand up.
Eje ka na wa soke.
I stand on the power of God.
Wa do ninu agbara Olorun.
Isaiah 45:11 says, give me authority upon the work of my hand. Matthew 18:18 says, anything I lose shall be loosed in the heavens.
Mark 16:17
says, this sign shall abide on those that believe. I stand on this
word.
Lord, according to your expression to me this early, in this week of conventions, any hearers of this powerful prayer that is saying amen wherever they might be, I knock and I sanction situation that will cause or prompt people to say that's good to occur to them. Hand together unto the Lord. Let's put our hand together. Yes, continue to say God is good. God is good. Let's have our respective say we are. Amen.
Amen.
He's a good God and we continue to show his goodness to us. Amen, amen, and amen.
Amen, Jesus.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Let's open our Bible right now. As we enter into the chapter of message from on throne. I pray that the world shall act to be blessings to our souls, damnation to the kingdom of darkness, and glorification to heavens in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Luke chapter 1.
Luke ore kini.
From verse 5.
What yes I can.
There was in the days of Herod, the king of Judea, a certain priest named Zechariah of the course of Abia, and his wife was of the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. And they were both righteous before God, walking in all the commandments and ordinances of the law blameless.
Nigba ojo erodu oba Judea alufa kan wa ni ipa ti Abia oruke a ma je Sakaraya aya re si se okan ninu awon omo benin Aroni oruko re a si ma je Elizabeth awon mejeji si se olododo ni waju Olorun won rin ni gbogbo ofin ohun ilan Oluwa ni ailegan.
What simply blinked to my heart is being a righteous Christian for the Lord.
Into what you have to say, our Baba alone, and did you Christian no Lord do for Oluwa?
Being a righteous Christian unto the Lord.
Did you Christian no Lord do for Oluwa?
Amen.
Amen.
Here we could see how the Bible narrated the reputations of this family. Family of Zechariah and Elizabeth.
Idile Zechariah ati Elizabeth.
We base our study especially on that verse 6 again.
Ao si agbeyewo kokojo lori ese kefa ye lekan si.
To see some facts about reputations which Bible narrated on them.
Kabo awon yi e ti Bible so nipa idile yi.
Family.
Idile.
When we mention family, we are referring to a husband and his wife.
Ti a ba soro nipa idile, a soro nipa oko ati aya.
So that is a reputable Christian family.
O je idile Christiani to dara.
Amen, people of God.
Amen.
Don't forget that caption, being a righteous Christian for the Lord.
Ẹ má jẹ́ ká gbàgbé àkórí ẹ, jíjẹ́ Kristẹnu olódodo fún Olúwa.
Here we could suddenly see how Bible recorded about their reputation as being faithful souls.
Ní bíbẹ̀, a ó rí bíbélì ṣe ṣe àkọsílẹ̀ rẹ̀ gẹ́gẹ́ bí ó ti di olódodo sí Ọlọ́run.
First and foremost,
ọ̀kọ́kọ́ náà,
as we are Christian today,
bí a ṣe jẹ́ Kristẹni lénìí,
can God identify us as Christian, as righteous Christians?
Sí Ọlọ́run lè dáwọ́ àmọ̀ tàbí ṣó lè sọ gẹ́gẹ́ bí pé a jẹ́ Kristẹni olódodo.
Let's settle up that firstly.
Ẹ jẹ́ ká kọ́kọ́ yanjú ìyẹn náà lákọ̀ọ́kọ́.
Can God identify us as righteous Christians?
Sí Ọlọ́run lè dáwọ́ àmọ̀ gẹ́gẹ́ bí Kristẹni olódodo.
There are many Christians in the world.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ Kristẹni ní bẹ nínú ayé.
There are many ministers in the world of today.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ikọ̀ ríjú ló wà ní ayé tèní.
Many church planters, many GOs and prophets and so on.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ olùdásílẹ̀ àti àwọn alásọtẹ́lẹ̀ àtàwọn wòlíì bẹ́ẹ̀ bẹ́ẹ̀ lọ.
But if you take a sand glance about them, you discover that the righteous souls are few.
Tí a bá wò wọ́n dáadáa tí a ti gbé yan tí a gbé wọn yẹ̀wò, a ó rí pé àwọn tó jẹ́ olódodo nu wọn, wọn ò wọ́pọ̀.
Few are those that are righteous.
Àwọn tó jẹ́ olódodo wọn kéré púpọ̀.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I pray that power to live righteously, the Lord will endow it on us in Jesus' name.
Agbára láti gbé ìgbé ayé olódodo, Ọlọ́run yóò yọ̀ǹda ẹ̀fà lórúkọ Jésù.
Let's review that verse 6.
Ẹ jẹ́ ká wo ẹsẹ̀ kẹfà yẹ.
We could see, and they were both righteous before God.
Àwọn méjèèjì sì ṣe olódodo níwájú Ọlọ́run.
There we could see three things being dictated on their account. In respect of their reputation.
Níbẹ̀ yẹ, a ó rí ohun mẹ́ta èyí tí a sọ nípa àwọn tó jẹ́ ohun tó lágbára.
Number one.
Àkọ́kọ́.
The Bible mentions that they were both righteous before him.
Bíbélì sọ wípé àwọn méjèèjì jẹ́ olódodo níwájú rẹ̀.
Righteous family.
Olódodo, ìdílé olódodo.
Amen.
Àmì.
Amen.
Àmì.
Secondly to that.
Ẹlẹ́kejì sí yẹ.
Walking in all the commandments and ordinances.
Wọ́n rìn nínú gbogbo òfin àti ìlànà Olúwa.
That is in their work of ministerial assignment.
Ìyẹn túmọ̀ sí nínú iṣẹ́ ìránṣẹ́ tí a gbélé wọn lọ́wọ́.
In your own ministerial assignment, are we walking uprightly?
Nínú iṣẹ́ ìránṣẹ́ tí a gbélé mi àti ìwọ náà lọ́wọ́, ṣé a rìn èdè níbi bẹ̀?
And thirdly,
ẹlẹ́kẹta,
underline blameless.
Ẹ jẹ́ ká fàlà sí, wọ́n jẹ́ aláìlẹ́gàn.
We want to base our study on these three principles now.
A fẹ́ bá gbé ẹ̀kọ́ wa lórí àwọn kókó mẹ́ta wọ̀nyí.
If you be conversant with our message, I want to remember that three things dictated to you last time.
Tó bá jẹ́ tá bá jẹ́ tó máa ń gbọ́ ọ̀rọ̀ bàbá wa dáadáa, àwọn fẹ́ ran wa létí àwọn ọ̀rọ̀ mẹ́ta tó ti bá wa sọ ní sẹ́yìn wá.
You are being told about three specific things that can prompt or qualify you for eternity.
Wọ́n sọ kókó mẹ́ta fún wa èyí tí ó lè mú wa dé ìjọ Ọlọ́run.
The other time.
Nígbà tó kọjá yẹn.
I know many have forgotten that.
Bàbá wọn mọ̀ pé ọ̀pọ̀ ti gbàgbé yẹ.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Here you discover that three things reflecting in their life as well.
Níbi bẹ̀, a ó rí pé kókó mẹ́ta yìí ó ń fara hàn nínú ayé àwọn ìdílé yìí.
You are told about number one, honesty.
Bàbá wa sọ àkọ́kọ́ fún wọn jẹ́ ẹni kó máa jẹ́ olùfọkàntán.
Honesty is meant by righteousness.
Olùfọkàntán jẹ́ ẹni tó jẹ́ olódodo.
Which the Bible is saying on their account.
Èyí Bíbélì sọ nípasẹ̀ àwọn ìdílé yìí.
You are told that time that righteousness is found in one's acts.
Olódodo, ìjẹ́ olódodo. Oúnjẹ àárín nínú ọkàn ènìyàn.
Is being found in one act.
Àárín nínú ìṣe ènìyàn.
So in our act, righteousness is being displayed.
Nínú ìṣe wa ni olódodo láti fi hàn.
Do you know we combine at times and make it as being similar but they are different to one another.
Ṣe mọ̀ pé tá a bá pápọ̀ nígbà mi, ó fẹ́ dàbí ìgbà tó bá jọrọ, ṣùgbọ́n ó yàtọ̀ síra.
Righteousness is a bit different to faithfulness. Many times we combine them.
Lọpọ igba la ma so won papo.
Has been the same.
Wipe o je bakan na.
Ne.
Kori be.
There is difference.
O ya iyato wa laarin
won. Quite distinction.
O iyato wa laarin mejeji.
Second thing is faithfulness.
Ikeji ni ije olotito.
Is found in one's ordinance.
A o de ninu ilana eniyan, ilana eniyan.
In his service.
Ninu ise isin.
Righteousness is in one
acts.
I will re-explain it so that you may get it
better. So
faithfulness is in one ordinance, the ordinance you render to your creator.
Ije olotito ye o wa ninu ise si wa eyi ti an se si eleda wa
is equivalent to walking in all commandments an ordinance of God in this family we are talking about.
Eyi o ja mo ati o si se mo ti se ni waju ni sise ni waju Olorun nipase ebi ti an soro nipase yi.
And that third one.
Ele keta yi.
You are told about Christian character.
A so nipa iwa awon Christiani.
Christian character.
Iwa awon Christiani.
So that is fun. That one is related to our attitude.
Iye tumo si ise wa.
Behavior.
Bi a ti nse.
So if I'm so faithful.
Ti o ba je olotito.
Living transparent holiness life.
Ti a n gbe igbe aye iwa mimo.
Be so brutal to my neighbor.
So bo ta buru si eni ti a ba gbe
papo. No any reputation in the community.
Ko si oro to dara ni agbegbe
wa. So wicked to people accompanying. Accompany people.
Aburu si awon ti o ba wa ko worin.
All that faithfulness and holiness is to not and nullify.
Gbogbo eje olotito ati iwa mimo ye o ja si asan o si pare.
Hallelujah. If you could remember three things were mentioned under one of the of these things.
Se abale on meta meta yi ti aso labi awon akori koko ti aso sile yi.
In one honest lie.
Nigba ninu olufokatan igbe aye niyan.
That is meant by tantamount to righteousness which I said.
Eyi to tun fe jomo je olododo ti baba wa so nipa.
So under that if you are righteous.
Ni abe ye ti aba je olododo.
So righteous that your righteousness will touch your Christian life.
Ije olododo
that's number one. That your righteousness will build reputation in your family.
Ije olododo ye yo fun wa ni in to dara ninu idile wa.
And the third, they will touch your business.
Eleketa eyo fowo kan ise wa.
In these three areas we can discover or discern your righteousness.
Ninu ona meta lati le ri ije olododo wa.
That is why I'm surprised about some Christians today.
To bi ya baba nipa awon Christiani kan leni.
Whenever they enter into business contracts.
Nigba ti won ba ti lo gba ise kan lowo eniyan kan.
Yes, this contract will is going to cost you 100,000.
Ise yi e ona 100,000.
That is cost of materials. As a Christian together, what can you amend? Which area are you going to amend things for us?
Never
you talk about that again. So this is not, business is business. Christianity separately. If your Christian life cannot override the business assumption or arrangement or contract, why are you Christian then?
Igbe aye Christiani o ba ti le bori sowo kini di to fi wa je Christiani gba na.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You are a Christian now.
O je Christiani bayi.
Either you are passenger carrier.
Boya o je ni to je en to wa oko.
So you are just being constrained, please. This is the last pen, I want you to help me.
I want be okay. Owo to ku lowo mi ni ejo eran mi lowo.
You now reply by saying, can I constrain people selling fuel for us?
Se wa da pada pe se mi na le ma bi awon pe ke ma so bayi fun mi.
Please don't constrain me the name of God at all.
Jomo pe mi ni oruko Oluwa rara rara.
You can't say that one in filling station now.
Oh, le so bayi ni bi ti a tin repo.
It means you relegate your Christian life and holiness is not maintained by you.
Ituma yi ja si pe orin irin ajo Christiani o ja gbogbo e wale ati gbe igbe aye wa mimo.
is a priority in human life. It affects what you tackle. It reflects in what's a business. In Christian life is reflected. And in the family, they acknowledge and say, oh, this is a true Christian family. That is righteousness. Equivalent to that first priority in the life of Zechariah and Mommy Elizabeth.
Elizabeth,
Bible says, both of them were righteous. Righteous to themselves. In their service and others. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Blessing faithfulness now. Three things found under faithfulness is this. Faithfulness in reflects in your conversations. If you are faithful enough, your yes will be yea, nay, nay.
Who
say yes here and say no there?
Oh, this is Ben, because you're coming back on Ben.
You won't talk and one thing here and say another thing here.
Oh, this song can be continued on some.
You say it's white here and there is yellowish.
Oh, this song won't perform me by go pelty yellow bell.
So your word will be the same. If a family, if they are faithful to one another, it's very abusive if they say, I can't believe you. Okay, call the name of God before I believe you. This home expenses, the cash that was taken in the morning, even I add more, it's not enough. Call the name of Christ. Okay, make oath before I believe you. They are far to faithfulness in that family then. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Faithfulness will reflect in conversation to one another. Faithfulness. Those that are used to appear in the presence of God anytime, anyhow, is lack of Christian faithfulness. Faithfulness will reflect in your time maintenance. You will always be baffled about time. Our program is 5:30. Our program is 6 o'clock. Our program is this also time. In fact, it will be as something arresting you, something shocking you, causing you to be restless. So as to maintain that time.
Yo ma kan wa lo minuto ba tin to akoko to ye ka bo an wa ji oluwa ni pe ah akoko ti to je ki tete ma lo kankan yo ma ru wa soke yo si ma ta wa la pe ka sa tete gbe.
Faithfulness. If you say yes, please help me to by his grace till the ending, I will balance you back. Before that appointed time, you are not in position of which they should call to remind you about your conversation.
Oh, sini koto ye kan tun pe on pada pe kan ran o leti nkan to ti so.
Hello, Sister Florence. You mentioned ending the other time. And today is a third. It's lack of faithfulness. Anything that we make your agreement to be uttered, before it is being uttered, before it is being change, that person will be carried along even period it happened. Faithfulness is one key to eternity. I won't go to that occasions. Getting there, they saw you kuru. See, Sister Olawoye that said she won't be able to make it.
Hey,
Hello, my sister. I bet you said you won't be able to make it.
Hey,
in fact, I even want to call you. Unfaithfulness. Unfaithfulness. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
These are keys to eternity. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
So it touch our conversations. Number two, time maintenance or agreements. And the third is our ordinances in the sight of God. Our ordinance. What you pay for the Lord. What you offer unto the Lord for his glory. Faithfulness. Faithfulness. Yes, I used to pay God worship. I used to do this unto my Lord. Oh, my God asked for this in the Bible and is capitally established that I should give this unto him if I want to be faithful. Even though you are dying, you will maintain that faithfulness. You will maintain that faithfulness. Faithfulness never changes. Never perfected. Is ever remain afar. And talk of character. We are still going back to that family now. So that faithfulness that bring the second point is the one they are referring to in that number two reputations in the family. If you see it again, walking in the commandments and ordinances, that is meant by faithfulness. In ordinances and commandments, anything God says, is it first fruits? This family, all the commandments and ordinances, is it firstborn of our livestock? They will render it. Is it talk of is it offering or thanksgiving or building token? The Bible says they are faithful to all ordinances. Those are ordinances you offer to God. All things he demands of us which we offer, they are referred to ordinances. Faithfulness. Lastly, there, blameless, tantamount to character. They wash this family. They are forgiving. They are nice. Blameless. Three things under blameless. You are told that day. If you are a reputable Christian in character, we will find humility. We will find obedience. That is why people used to say, he's so disobedient in character. In his character. You see, that's why people saying that. He's so disobedient in character. So, in once a character, attitudes, if is well maintained, in him there will be humility. He will find it easy to obey. Obey God. Obedience to parents. Obedience to authority of the organizations or either where he work with, either government or company, he will obey their rules and regulations.
Yo ma gboro si ase bi to ti sise boya se ijoba ni tabi ise ti ara re tabi ise ti awon aladani.
People where is working won't be say, ah, we have never seen this type of Christian you call yourself.
Awon eyan o ni ma so ni bi to ti se pe ati ati iriru Christiani to pinra re yi ri.
Ah ah, when you are so difficult to, you know, to amend or to say sorry to your boss, and you call yourself Christian. And your characters, we are fed up of it. So it means humility be that. Is Christian character condemned? So number one, humility, obedience, and charity. Amen. It will be lovely. She will be lovely. Lovers of others. So do you know what love doing? I think you read that book of Romans. If you are lovely, you will be generous. If you are lovely, you will help people. That is what is found in love. If you are lovely and you are so cunning, automatically is not Christian love be that. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says love does not seek his own opinion alone. Seek the opinions of people that every people should enjoy together. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. If one has these three keys, it is then there will be assurance for his eternity. Now, let's now make evaluations of this family on these three principles they had. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says they were righteous. That is, being honest. So honesty is found in them. That is their own righteousness. Then faithful in all ordinances and commandments. So that is faithfulness in them. And in their character, they are blameless. They were blameless. They can't say, ah, hey, Mama Elizabeth, he is used to talk jargon. He can curse from now to tomorrow. Your anger is too much. You too much always been indignated. Anything like this will be set in fury and being aggressed with your husband. It's not Mommy Elizabeth. Blameless. They don't say about our daddy Zechariah. Baba so cunning. So frivolous. Stingy. Not at all or nothing like that in his account, in his reputation. All we find in our father Zechariah is he is blameless. I wish to maintain such as for me, no? For people to say, ah, Abrajio, in fact, is blameless. in character. He is forgiving. He is so nice. He is so kind. He is so humble. In fact, if you have any matter, he listen carefully to adhere to what you are saying. He's blameless. Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
I pray ability to maintain this scriptural emphasis today and henceforth, the Lord will endow it on us in Jesus' name. Now, upon this, I want to show you one thing that occurred. The second part of it is about tests of faith being observed in this family. Have you ever heard of that? Whenever you are faithful, being a default person in the house of God, so industrious and effective in his service, in responsibilities, either workers, instrumentalists, or securities, or others. And the next thing is test. This God is not even good to me. Or people will say, upon now he's so being a default person. Look at what happened to him. Today Christians don't want test anymore. But there is a test of faith. Upon this, about this family, let's see what happened in verse 7. Let's go directly to verse 7. The Bible says the lodge barrenness. Can you see? So, Mama seemed to be found infertile.
Mama Elizabeth,
can you see? What of if it were you? No, I won't serve God again. How can I be faithful to this length? So industrious, blameless, obeying and adhering to every commandment and ordinances. Should God not? Is God? Why should God not answer me? I won't work for him again. But this family didn't do church. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Ability to be perfect in the sight of God, God will give it unto us in Jesus' name. Let's see what happened to the family. And they had no child. Because Elizabeth was barren, and they both were now well stricken in years. See to that, people of God. The Bible could tell us that they were stricken in years. It means that length of barrenness are so long. Yet, look at verse 9. Verse 8. And it came to pass that while he executed the priest's office before God in order of his cause. That is, he wasn't relent. He wasn't backslide. He wasn't weary or large to be exhausted. He continued in that his ordinance. He continued in that his faithfulness. Can you see? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you are somebody that is generous today, you do give unto people, and immediately they call you for one big contract and same has been missed. You say, no. Whether what I'm doing is not pleasing God. If it pleases God, I don't suppose to miss this contract. I will stop giving. It's better I stop liberality. But the Bible says, as for this man, they say, thank you. He executed that, or he maintained that office, never looking back, not wearied, not exhausted, always on race, always at ready. Can you see? I pray we'll never be wearied in Jesus' name. But let's see the result finally. In that verse 13, after God beheld, okay, Zechariah, you still continue this office upon all you are old in age now, been stricken in years. Oh, let's see verse 13. Let's see conclusion of heaven on them. But the angel says unto him, fear not, for the prayer is hard, and thy wife Elizabeth shall bear thee a son, and thou shalt call his name John. Let people praise the Lord. Where he was maintaining that office, executing the priesthood responsibilities in the house of God, doing all he could do as his assignment and responsibilities, he had fear not. Thank you, Lord. Your wife shall bear thee a son, and you call his name John. That is, we have a God that is never fail. I have a God who never fail. Ah, I have a God who never fail. Jesus never fail. Ah, he never fail. Forevermore. Amen. Jesus never fail. Amen. My father never fail. Amen. Jesus never fail. Oh yes.
Jesus never fail. Jesus
never fail. You will never meet disappointment in him in Jesus' name. Because of his industriousness in the sight of God, he was being surprised at the end. Hallelujah. And finally, on this family, look at verse 24. And after those days, his wife Elizabeth conceived and he has served 5 months, saying, does the Lord dealt with me in the days wherein he looked upon, looked mean to take away my reproach among men. What is your reproach today? Is removed in the name of Jesus. Let's see one thing more before we round up. What prompts their faithfulness? I want to show you one thing, no? Can you see? In that verse 5 again, there was in the days of Herod, the king of Judea, a certain man named Zechariah of the course of Abia, and his wife was of the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth.
Nigba ojo erodu oba Judea alofa kan wa ni ipa ti Abia oruko ara ma je Zachariah aya re si se okan ninu awon omo obirin Aaron oruko re a si ma je Elizabeth.
Husband
oko
in the course of Abia
ni ipa ti Abia.
Who is Abia? The former senior priest of the law. You want to see lineage of Abia? Let's see where he belonged to. See 1 Samuel chapter 8. You discuss the emanations of that man that is not an ordinary source. Let's say verse 2, chapter 8. I read verse 2 there. The Bible says, now the name of his firstborn was Joel, and the name of the second, Abia. They were judged in Bathsheba. Now, let's go back there now. Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So the trace of his lineage, that is Zechariah's lineage, was from Abia through Prophet Samuel. That means he was offering of Samuel, that great prophet of the Lord, who was honorable in the sight of God. Hallelujah. So definitely he must be honest. He must be faithful. Let's see wife again. There we are even made to know the source of the wife. They say daughter of Aaron. Aaron. Plus Samuel. Fire. So automatically, the source of John was clean, clear, and pure.
So
definitely, their faithfulness is something hereditary. Amen. It's quite different to a Christian brother that went to Habali's home and impregnated somebody where he indulged himself in palm wine. Fire from blood, fire oriented. Fire source. So devil must flee away. Though they were being tempted, they were tested, but victory at last. So your foundation is highly essential. You youths, your foundation is very essential. You must know where foundation must be erected, so as to be firm. Not anyhow. Though despite their foundation has been holy from the beginning, they receive tests. But before open their eyes, God says, I must honor this foundation. Devil, pim. Zechariah, fear not. Your foundation is sin. It's in sight of me. You shall bear a son. How do you build your foundation? You youth, what types of foundation do you want to have? What type of foundation do you want to build? Being a righteous Christian in the sight of God. We ministers, what type of foundation are we planting church upon? from Samuel background, from Aaron background. Hallelujah. They build their family on solid rock. Some want to establish church today. Some want to establish church today. You put a young baby in the altar. Is that sand foundation at the corner of a pillar? Pregnant woman there. What will be the end of church organization or church? The business you want to establish, you put what do you call it? You put a black horse at every corners of that business. What types of foundation do you maintain? Being a righteous Christian. Let's go and cry to the Almighty God. Let's go and cry to the Almighty God. Foundation must it really means in everything we are doing. It matters most in everything we are doing. Foundation of family, foundation of business, foundation of venture, foundation of life, foundation of Christianity, foundation of your own born again life. Foundation of the children before you have children. What should be the foundation of this children I want to have? Foundation master is really means something. Matamos, let's rise up on our feet. Lord, I want to have solid foundation for you in my Christian life, in my family, in my business. I want to build upon the rock. Give me good foundation. People of God, cry where you are. Foundation. Pray very well. 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 You want to date to have a family. You.